If any of the Jamar Chase doubters haven't already deleted their tweets from the preseason, I'm sorry, but it's far too late now. Those tweets looked silly from the moment they were sent, but now that Chase has gone out and played like a number one receiver for 3 straight weeks, they look downright hilarious. Of course, there's no denying that Chase had a bad case of the yips in the preseason. He dropped all but one of his 5 targets that came his way in the 3 exhibition games, and the reports out of training camp weren't much better. He also had that quote about NFL footballs not having stripes that was taken completely out of context and run into the ground, so it was the perfect storm for people to label him a bust before he ever even saw a regular season snap. We all should know by now that drops are a volatile stat, but the most astounding thing here that people seem to be missing is that it was preseason.
How did this happen? We're smarter than this.
Like, seriously? Preseason? Don't talk to me about preseason. You kidding me? Preseason? Jamar Chase was one of the most highly touted receivers to come out in years, and you're going to throw him out over preseason? Don't forget that that was Chase's first game action in nearly 2 years, as he opted out of the 2020 season while at LSU. The guy put up nearly 1,800 receiving yards and 20 touchdowns in 2019 as a 19-year-old while outplaying last year's rookie phenom Justin Jefferson. And Chase's player profiler workout metrics were most comparable to those of Odell Beckham Jr. What are we doing here? From 4 drops in 3 preseason games to 4 touchdown catches in 3 regular season games, Jamar Chase is silencing the doubters quicker than anybody could have possibly imagined. But how good has Chase been through 3 games though? Am I overstating things? Let's take a gander at some statistics. Through 3 weeks, Chase has 11 receptions for 220 yards, which is the 8th highest total for a rookie 21 years or younger in his first 3 career games, just 1 yard behind Randy Moss in his spectacular rookie year. Chase's 4 receiving touchdowns are tied for the most for a rookie in a team's 3 games, and he's the only 21-year-old to meet that total. Additionally, his 4 receiving TDs this season eclipses the total of all other rookie wide receivers this year combined. And Chase has been doing most of his damage by roasting DBs down the field. He has a receiving touchdown of 30 plus yards in each of his first 3 career games. He's the only player in NFL history to do this since the merger. His 20.0 yards per reception mark is 3rd in the league among players with at least 10 catches. He also has the 4th highest PFF grade on deep ball targets. And not only does Chase have the highest PFF grade of any rookie wideout, but he has the highest grade of any rookie offensive player, and the 5th highest grade of any rookie overall. His PFF grade over his first 3 games is better than players like Julio Jones, OBJ, and AJ Green over their respective first 3 contests. Chase's 2.75 yards per route run also ranks 8th among receivers with at least 10 receptions. And one thing is for certain, if you line up against Chase in single coverage, you're going to have a long day as a defense. Chase's 182 yards in one-on-one situations is the best in the league, as are his 4 scores on such plays. And you have to remember, Chase's box score stats look this great even while playing for the 2nd-least pass-happy team in the league in the Bengals. Cincinnati has thrown just 75 passes this year, while the league average is a whopping 105. As such, Chase's efficiency numbers look even better, as his 55.4% DVOA mark ranks him 4th in the NFL. But of course, that's still not to say that he fares poorly otherwise, as he still places 7th in DYAR. So yeah, Jamar Chase has been pretty good. Now imagine what he and Joe Burrow can do together when either one of them finally has more than a handful of NFL games under their belt. The two have picked up their connection right where they left off at LSU, but there have still been a couple plays left on the field that could have boosted their numbers even more. But that hasn't really mattered much because Chase brought his crafty and nuanced route running with him to the NFL. He impressed from his very first catch in the NFL when he put Bashaud Breeland in a blender with some stutter steps at the top of his route before breaking it off and using strong hands to haul in the pass. It should have been obvious from that moment, preseason drops be damned. Jamar Chase is a star, and opposing defensive backs have officially been put on notice.